Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD.
Today I'm going to explain about different types of shuttle vectors. Usually, a shuttle vector are capable of replicating in two or more types of host. They can replicate autonomously or integrate into host genome and replicate when the host replicate. Commonly used for transporting gene from one organism to another, like from a eukaryote to a prokaryote, or transforming from animal to a plant cell. Prokaryotic vector cannot exist and work in eukaryotic cells because the system of two group of organism varies. Prokaryotes lack introns, while eukaryotes consists of introns. Therefore, vector with two origin of replication were constructed, which may exist in both prokaryotes as well as the eukaryotes. Hence, they are called as shuttle vector. One of the example is the glowing tobacco, which was produced by the insert of luciferase gene to the plasmid and transformed to the bacterium. This plasmid was grown in the agrobacterium amplified in the agrobacterium in large quantity, and it was transformed to infect the tobacco plant, which led to the glowing tobacco. Now, as I told, this vector can propagate in two different hosts. Usually the prokaryotic host will be the E. coli, whereas the eukaryotic host species could be mammalian cell, insect cell, or yeast. Depending on this, different types of shuttle vectors are formed. E. coli and yeast shuttle vector, which is also called as YEP13 vector. Now, this YEP13 illustrates several general characteristic features of a yeast cloning vector. First, it is a shuttle vector, as well as it has a 2 micrometer origin of replication and a selectable LEU2 gene. This YEP13 also include the entire PBR322 sequence and can therefore replicate and be selected for both yeast and E. coli host. Since this vector can replicate in two different hosts, they have two origin of replication site. One is for the E. coli, like in this vector, one is for the E. coli where it will replicate in the E. coli host, whereas another one is SV40 which replicate in the phage. Depending on the vector, this origin of replication also varies. Now, this SV40 origin site is from SV40 polyoma virus. Now, this SV40 origin containing plasmid replicate in cells that are infected with SV40 polyoma virus express the large T antigen. HEK293 T cells. These cells are stably transfected with large T antigen expressing construct, which was selected with G418 or genitisin. Episomal replication. DNA does not become diluted with cell division as quickly as non-replicating plasmid. Another example for E. coli yeast shuttle vector is YEP352, which is about 5181 base pair. It consists of a origin of replication site for E. coli, as well as another origin of replication, that is 2 micron origin replication for Saccharomyces cerevisiae. It consists of a lac promoter and URA3 promoter, lac promoter, there is a multiple cloning site. Next is the E. coli mammalian shuttle vector. Most of them are DNA virus with a circular genome to which bacterial origin and selectable marker have been added. Example are adeno-associated virus, adenovirus or baculovirus. Now, in case of E. coli and insect shuttle vector, example is the back-to-back vector. Here, the transform F. E. coli with a genome of viral DNA and even with a P. fast back and a helper plasmid. Now, this helper plasmid helps in transposition of the protein, and after transfection with PFAST back 1 and helper plasmid along with the recombinant virus into the E. coli, transposition of T7 element to mini at TN7 takes place, that is a transposable element, then which led to composite back mid. Later, isolation of the mixture of plasmid DNA and retransform E. coli will be done, which led to pure composite backmid. Then isolation of backmid DNA and transfect insect cells will lead to pure composite virus. So in this way, shuttle vector will be used in insect. Uses of shuttle vector. It might be difficult to recover the recombinant DNA molecule from a transformed yeast colony. This is not such a problem in case of YEPS, which is present in yeast cell primarily as a plasmid, but with other yeast vectors which may integrate into one of the yeast chromosome, purification might be impossible. This is a disadvantage because in many cloning experiment, purification of recombinant DNA is essential in order to correct construct to be identified by, for example, DNA sequencing. The standard procedure when cloning in yeast is therefore to perform the initial cloning experiment with E. coli and to select recombinant in this organism. Recombinant plasmid can then be purified, characterized and correct molecule introduced into the yeast.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.